Hello and welcome to Method Integration User Tutorials. My name is Errol and we are going through a series of videos on activities. Today we're going to take a look at editing activities. Now, there are many reasons why you'd want to edit an activity. For example, maybe you want to complete it. However, I'm going to show you some best practices using the follow-up activity you created way back in tutorial video number 2 of activities. Here I am already in the activities tab and I can see in the activities list this follow-up activity number 104, which was created from the previous video I just mentioned. Of course, the activity which spawned this follow-up is not here because it was completed. If I were to go to the occurrences, I could find that original activity. It was in June. And here it is, if you can remember from activity video number 2 where we discussed scheduling a follow-up. We have the first meeting where Bob Crenshaw came in to say hi, and from there we scheduled this follow-up. So let's edit this. Let's say I come in, I see I have this activity, and I will click the go to link to edit it. Now this activity number 104, it was created as a follow-up from activity number 103. And in case you forget that, we have the previous activity comments right here. And if you can't remember where those previous comments came from, that's why we have recent history. Just scroll on down and you will see related to activity number. And there we see it's related to activity number 103. And that's the activity that created the current activity we're in. How cool is that? Okay, let's continue with this example. We're in activity number 104. Let's say the meeting was complete and now the result of that is that Bob Crenshaw wants us to call him again because he likes our company or something. So I'll just put that in. And because he wants us to call him maybe tomorrow, that means we schedule another follow-up. So I'll schedule a follow-up for tomorrow. I'll make the type phone call outgoing. It's already set for tomorrow. So I'm going to complete, save, and back this activity. But before I do that, I want you to understand that this completes activity number 104 and it will make a brand new activity because I scheduled a follow-up. So I'll complete, save, and back this. And now my activity list is empty because this only shows activities that are active and on or before today. So I'm going to set my filter view to all my occurrences and then I'll set another filter for June. And now I can see the original activity, number 103, which started this whole thing, and the follow-up activity from that, number 104, and then the follow-up activity from that, number 105. I hope this makes sense. I'm just chaining activities one after the other. So let's say it's tomorrow, and I gave Bob Crenshaw a call. I'm going to edit activity number 105. I'm going to hit the go-to link. Remember, activity number 105 is related to activity number 104. We created the follow-up of activity number 105 from activity number 104, and in previous activity comments, we see the comments from activity number 104. Let's put in the comments for this activity. Wants to have a dinner meeting to discuss in detail. We gave him a call, now he just wants another meeting. At least it's free dinner, haha. So let's schedule another follow-up, and it's a meeting, and a dinner meeting. There's no dinner meeting here, just normal meeting. Okay, complete, save, and back this. Now, I hope you're getting the hang of this, especially since I've done it 3 times. And if you aren't, you can always just re-watch this video, because it's awesome. Okay, let's end this. I've prolonged it long enough. Go to activity number 106. Here we are. You can see the previous activity comments from activity number 105. And let's end this now. Meeting successful. Deal done! Now let's complete, save, and back this. Now I went through all of this, not because I like the sound of my own voice, but I wanted you to see how useful this can be to your business. You can keep an electronic trail of all your interactions with Bob. Or, well, maybe not Bob, but whomever your customers or clients are. And we're done! Huzzah! If you have any questions, by all means, leave them in the YouTube comments, or you can tweet us at Method CRM. I hope you have a great day and take care. Bye-bye.